Welcome back. I'm Wyatt Goolsby, in for Lauren Ashburn. Our next guest says polls are overstating the public's approval of Roe versus Wade, the landmark Supreme Court decision that recognized the constitutional right to an abortion. In National Review, Michael New writes, quote, since 1973, supporters of legal abortion have tried to convince the Supreme Court that Roe v. Wade enjoys very broad public support. However, a closer look at the survey data indicates that this is not the case. Michael New is a visiting assistant professor at Catholic University of America's Bush School of Business. He's also an associate scholar at the Pro-Life Charlotte Lozier Institute. Michael, welcome back to the program.
Oh, thanks for having me.
You say these polls are misleading. How so?
They're misleading in several ways. First off, in 2013, Pew researched this survey, and they found that many people weren't familiar with the Roe v. Wade decision. 20% hadn't heard of it, and 17% thought it dealt with an issue other than abortion. So a lot of people aren't even familiar with the decision itself. And even among the 60% who know it's an abortion decision, probably don't really understand the full implications of the decision. Roe v. Wade went beyond legalizing abortion in the first trimester. It effectively legalized abortion on demand and made it very difficult to regulate or limit even second or third trimester abortions. Also, people don't really understand the implications of a reversal or an overturn of Roe v. Wade. An overturn or reversal wouldn't ban abortion. It would simply return abortion policy to the states, and state legislatures would kind of arrive at their own conclusions. So there's several dimensions of the decision that people don't understand, and the polling data does not really reflect that.
Why do you think the data misleads the public on the issue? Is it intentional, in your view?
I think to a certain extent it is. I think a lot of these media outlets tend to be sympathetic toward legal abortion. I think they also realize Supreme Court at some level is sensitive to public opinion on abortion. And I think they kind of want to see to it that Roe v. Wade's kind of a quote-unquote super precedent and that there would be, and they want to make the case there would be kind of a backlash if it were overturned. But again, I think that people don't really understand the decision. They don't really understand the implications of a reversal. And I think the support for the decision is greatly overstated.
What do you think pro-life advocates can do to make sure their views are better heard and the picture is more balanced like it is realistically?
You know, I think one thing we can certainly do is do our own polling. I think that a lot of the polling questions that are asked aren't always helpful to pro-lifers. There's very good data indicating that people are very sympathetic toward limitations on second and third trimester abortions, and we need to get that out. And also, even looking at a broader question about who decides abortion policy, there's support for the pro-life position. Susan B. Anthony List recently conducted polls in several swing states asking, should the Supreme Court kind of dictate abortion policy, or should it be decided by state legislatures? And majorities of people in nearly every swing state preferred that policy be made by their own state legislatures and not the Supreme Court. So I think by doing our own polling, I think we can kind of counteract this narrative.
What impact is the nomination of Judge Brett Kavanaugh to the Supreme Court having on this discussion? A lot of pro-life people are pretty excited about that nomination.
I think that he'll certainly, his nomination, and if he's confirmed, would certainly help the pro-life movement. It's hard to say specifically what would happen. I mean, we don't know what kind of cases might be appealed to the Supreme Court. Mm-hmm. We don't know what kind of cases the Supreme Court might choose to hear. A relatively small percentage of appealed cases are even heard. So we really don't know what the future of abortion jurisprudence, you know, contains. But I think it is fair to say he'd be someone who'd be fairly sympathetic toward additional protections for the unborn. And I think he'd make it easier for people in the state level to do more to protect unborn children. And I think that's why pro-lifers are excited about this this nomination.
A lot of reasons for pro-lifers to be excited when thinking about the future. Michael New, visiting assistant professor of business at the Catholic University of America. Thanks so much for talking with us.
Oh, thanks for having me.